In this video, I'll be talking about the differences between Wayland and Xorg and which one you should choose to manage your display events in Linux. Okay, before I get going on this, I'm gonna just address the elephant in the room. I know I'm wearing a Microsoft certified professional shirt, but it was laundry day and I had this in my closet and I just threw it on. So, not too much hate, be kind in the comments, guys, and I'm gonna go ahead and jump into this video. So before I jump into the differences between Wayland and Xorg, I wanna kinda go over what they are. What do they do? Well, they're basically display servers that communicate and compose windows for applications. So what does that mean exactly? Well, that means if you go to pull up an application and the window comes up and it has a black screen, well, a lot of times that is either Wayland or Xorg having a seizure, so to speak. So they're very important. They're integral parts of actually how your display is managed, how things are displayed on your monitor. And that's really all they do. And they also help communicate graphic instances to remote terminals. So if I wanted to remote into a computer and then display and grab that display, typically it's done by, you know, Wayland or Xorg in this instance. And that's really what they are. So let's talk about Wayland first before we get to Xorg. It's kind of the new kid on the block. It's cleaner, it's supposedly a lot faster, and it's smaller than the Xorg package. It's not nearly as bloated. But it only comes prepackaged with Fedora that I know of. Almost everybody else packages it with Xorg. I knew Ubuntu 18.04 moved back to Xorg. I think they were had a trial there, and I think version 17 with Xorg. So almost everybody uses Xorg except for Fedora 29. I know it released and has Wayland enabled by default. So let's talk about Wayland right now. So my personal experience with Wayland is it just doesn't work very well for me. I've tried it on my main box here. It's got AMD graphics, which is pretty choice for Wayland. NVIDIA graphics has been reported not even to work very well with Wayland, at least not the proprietary drivers that NVIDIA offers. So very important to know, if you do install Fedora 29 and having a lot of issues right out of the gate, chances are Wayland is the cause, especially if you have an NVIDIA graphics card. So with that said, Wayland is supposedly a lot faster because it was programmed to be a lot cleaner and to fix a lot of the things that caused Xorg to bloat up in the first place. I haven't personally looked at the code, but many programmers say Wayland is just a lot better structure and should have a lot better future than Xorg. And many people are like, it's like 80-90% of the way there. It's just not all the way there, where Xorg is a fully baked product and many people are already using it. So there's also a couple drawbacks, but I'm going to go ahead and cover that in Xorg right now. So let's say my personal experience with Xorg. It's actually pretty good. I don't really have any complaints about Xorg, other than it's a bit dated and a lot of people say it's not going to be the future. It's just kind of the past, but it works. It really works. It works a lot better than Wayland, at least in my experiences. And I wanted to kind of touch on this real fast. There's some things Xorg offers that I actually love that Wayland does not. The first is X11. What is X11? X11 is kind of like, it's a way to transmit your screen through an SSH instance, and a lot of times to where I can be remote and SSH into my Linux box and then pull up a gedit. You know, if I wanted a graphics editor, and it can actually pull in a full graphics window, and I can use my mouse, scroll through, and I'm not sitting there in Nano or Vim trying to edit things. So it's really important to know X11 capability. Many people don't use X11, so you're like, I don't care, Titus, just move on to the next thing. So, but X11 for me was a big deal. For most people, it's not. The next thing, which is a big deal for almost everybody, is screen sharing. You'll notice by default in Fedora 29, you go into settings when it's on Wayland, screen sharing is nowhere to be found. It just disappears from settings, and that's because you can't really screen share using Wayland yet. I'm sure in the future that feature will be added, but right now Xorg is pretty much the only game in town. The good news is, as soon as you disable Wayland and Xorg takes over in Fedora, that screen sharing option comes right back and works great. So that's a good thing to know, especially when it comes to that. Xorg by default pretty much works with all the applications. Almost everything's designed around it or has been designed around it. So many graphic or display managers only work with Xorg. So when it comes to Wayland, you're pretty much jailed into using GNOME only. With Xorg, you can use Cinnamon, you can use KDE, you can use a lot of other display managers out there without having, you know, a lot of the hiccups you have with Wayland. Where Wayland, you're pretty much stuck on GNOME because it's run by the GNOME team, I believe. And if that's wrong, please let me know in the comments below, and I'd love to correct that. But that's just the breakdown between Wayland and Xorg. Thanks for watching my video. If you have any feedback or comments, please let me know below. And if you'd like to see more tech videos, hit the subscribe button and check me out on my website, christitus.com.